Hi, my name is Johnny Vaught, and this is The Review, where I review the latest and the greatest movies for Bedford TV. Today, I'm going to be discussing Vice. Before we get to that, just a little bit about me and the show. Here on The Review, I will always offer my recommended viewing guide. I will recommend that you go and see it if it's available in theaters, and I think that you would benefit from seeing it on a big screen while it's still available to see in theaters. I will recommend that you stream it if it's available to stream, and I think you could enjoy it just as much from the comfort of your own screen. And I will recommend that you skip it if I didn't enjoy it, and I don't think that you will either. Now, I am currently a hairstylist, but I do have my degree in history. I love history. I certainly enjoy American history. I feel like you don't really have a choice in that. When you grow up in the States, you're going to get more American history than any other sort of history. And with that knowledge going into Vice, I guess I didn't know that much about the vice presidency. It was a really cool movie to kind of like round out my knowledge about what the vice presidency is. I'd say that, unfortunately, the majority of my information came from the John Adams miniseries, which I truly enjoyed. It's amazing. You should check it out. So I guess I knew who Dick Cheney was in kind of a periphery way, but I didn't know too much about him. And one of the things that Vice does a great job of doing is explaining that that is by design. Dick Cheney doesn't want you to know very much about him. And with that in mind, I thought that Vice was really, really cool. It came out back on Christmas in 2018. It is just over 2 hours at 2 hours and 12 minutes. And I'll tell you what, this movie flies. When it finished, I was just flabbergasted. I didn't think that it dragged at all, and it certainly could have, because this is certainly a character-driven piece. There's not too much action in it, and the action that is in this movie is to, I guess, show the severity of some of his choices. I thought that they did a really, really cool job of making this a character-driven piece. It is rated R, certainly for content and for some of those action scenes, and it was just super cool. It was directed by Adam McKay, who actually directed Anchorman. And I didn't realize that he had directed Anchorman when I went into this, but there are some familiar faces from that movie in this. Steve Carell plays Donald Rumsfeld, another name that I was certainly familiar with, but as far as a character or a person, I did not know too much about specifically. And I think that Vice did a really cool job of giving me some information about some kind of contemporary historical figures. I really thought that it was cool the way that they portrayed them and the way that they took the time to really make these all into real people. I thought Steve Carell did an excellent job. I think that he does get credit for being an amazing actor, and I just want to give him some more accolades for being incredible in this, obviously showing his range. We all know him from The Office, of course. We all love that. If you don't, you should. You should watch it again. It's great. And also one of my favorite movies ever, Crazy Stupid Love. Now, one of my favorite parts of this movie was actually Jesse Plemons. Here on The Review, I do avoid all major spoilers, so I won't be able to talk too much more about his character, but he is one of my favorite actors today, and certainly one of my favorite performances of the last year was his role in Game Night. Loved that movie, loved that part. Definitely check it out now. Christian Bale plays Dick Cheney in this movie, and one of the things that I learned in researching for this episode is that the members of the Cheney family actually pronounce their name Cheney, which I'd never heard before, and I'm shocked, and they certainly don't go out of their way to correct people. Amy Adams played Dick Cheney's wife, Lynn, and she was a powerhouse in this movie. I generally love all of her performances. Certainly my favorite would be Enchanted a few years ago. Again, if you haven't seen Enchanted, it's available to you now, and it's incredible. Christian Bale really disappeared into this role in a way that he certainly can. There was a physical transformation. He gained over 45 pounds for the role, and I thought that he did a great job from portraying Dick Cheney for a large portion of his life. This movie begins in 1963, and it comes right up to the present, which I don't think is too much of a spoiler, because we know that Dick Cheney is still alive. There are other character actors in this movie that I thought did an amazing job, including Eddie Marson, who is excellent in Ray Donovan. And again, one of the movies that I thought was gonna make it really big and make a splash come prestige season, White Boy Rick. He was great in that last year. Sam Rockwell steals the show, though. He plays George W. Bush, and he has the physical mannerisms, the voice, the look down. I thought that he was incredible in this. I was really blown away. He's, again, generally good in everything. I really like Sam Rockwell. And in researching for this video, I was reminded of his part in Galaxy Quest, a movie that I will certainly be doing a review of as one of the greatest soon. I really, really enjoyed this movie. One of the things that I think that you will enjoy if you do end up seeing it is they really made some interesting directing choices. Adam McKay definitely wanted to make a movie. This story isn't told in a straightforward way, jumps around a little bit, and I think that they do an excellent job of making the different moods from the times, as well as just doing some things that are only available to do in film. I thought that it was really, really cool. And one of the things that you definitely want to do is stick around into the credits. There is a scene midway through the credits that is absolutely a joy. I certainly enjoyed Vice. It was nominated for Best Picture. It wasn't my favorite picture of the year, but it was certainly one that I think is valid for contention. I think that actually because it was nominated for Best Picture, it is a good idea to go and see Vice in theaters, if only to be part of the larger conversation. So if you have the possibility, certainly go and see Vice. My name is Johnny Vaught, and this has been The Review.